Today, I just want to talk about how I am studying to become a druid. Now, Max, aren't you already a druid? Yes. Yes, I am. Let's talk about that. So I am studying the OBOD druidry course. Specifically, I'm starting at their bard grade because that's just how it works. So OBOD is the Order of Bards, Obates, and Druids. The course is split into three levels. I'm also not sponsored, by the way, I'm just talking about how this particular bit of the course works. So the course is split into three levels, and each level, the bard course, I don't know about the other two yet because I haven't got there, but the bard level especially comes as 52 lessons, or gwersi, sorry if that's mispronounced. You get 52 little booklets which contain lessons and activities and little tidbits of wisdom. And these booklets are enough for one per week over the course of a year. However, you are encouraged to do this at your own pace, and that is exactly what I'm doing. You don't have to complete all three levels to call yourself a druid. So I'm doing the bardic grade, I'm still a druid. I'm studying druidry. This is how specifically I'm studying the OBOD bardic course and how I am studying druidry as a whole, including but not limited to the OBOD course. It's also worth noting, this is kind of a disclaimer, that OBOD asks you not to discuss the course details like at all and in depth, because it can kind of affect other people's own journey. So if I were to tell you that my favourite colour is green because it makes me feel, what, this is a really bad comparison, but it makes me feel wonderful, it symbolises growth and life to me, and it feels super fresh, and it looks like mint tastes, you are then going to, well, you might then associate looking at green with mint things. Again, this is a really bad comparison, but to preserve the individuality of the experiences that you can have and the opinions you can form and the results of some meditations and exercises, we just don't really talk about it that much. You can talk about it like with other people that have done the same thing, but don't give it away to newbies. So I'm not gonna do that, this isn't that. This is just how I am studying to be a druid. This is a 4-minute intro so far. Editing Max, sorry. I'm gonna start with the actual course itself, which I keep in this lovely little box with leaves on it, because druidry is about, to me, getting in touch with nature and trees, and they didn't have trees, but these leaves have come, some of these leaves have come off of trees. It's also just like a nice little box to have it in. This is where I keep all of my course study materials, and I'm not even going to show you some of them. Good job, Max. So I have a little tracker, which I'm also not going to show you because it's for me. But I will show you this. This has nothing to, well, this notebook did not come from the Order of Bards, Obates, and Druids. This notebook came from a stationery subscription because I have no self-control with my own adult money. And I'm a note taker, just as a scientist, I've always taken notes when I study stuff, so when I'm studying druidry, I'm taking notes. I'm not gonna show you the notes, and it's not required of the course. But I just take notes on things I find interesting, things that I might want to read outside and not necessarily have to bring the correct booklet with me. So this is just like a compilation of really cool things and thoughts and things to think about that I'll just take with me on a walk, so I don't have to pick up, say, this many of the booklets when I could just pick up this one and have it in there. And it's also just really pretty, and it's got sea things on the front, and I like sea things, and this is not the one right way to do it. That's just one thing that I find helpful because I have memory problems as a disabled person with brain fog sometimes. It just really helped me to have some stuff written down, so that's what I've done. But the most important way that I study the Obod course is by doing it in my own time. I have not been following one booklet a week, I have barely been following one booklet a month, because part of the journey is not rushing and taking the time that is natural to you to process all of the things and to think about the things and to really kind of get to grips with it. And there's some things in the courses that I have been like, oh, that's interesting, I want to do a bit more of a deep dive, and then I've done like 3 weeks of looking into this one very niche like point of interest. So that has been, yeah, it's designed to go at your own pace. It's designed to go no sooner than a year, but it's designed to take you as long as it takes, and I'm really glad that it does that, because there's no pressure for me to be like, oh no, I'm behind. So that's all I'm really going to say on that, and I really hope that that's not been, that I've not said too much to colour anyone's opinion of what the Bard course is. So that's step number one of how I'm studying to become a Druid. Let's put this down somewhere safe. Another thing that I've been doing is I've been listening to podcasts. I was never really much of a podcast fan, because, you know, being deaf doesn't help. Not really a listening to no video kind of thing. But Obod does Druidcast, which is a druidry podcast. And they do monthly episodes where they don't talk about course content, they just talk about interesting things. And I consider myself late to the party. I'm not late to the party, but they have got so many episodes. They have like years and years of episodes just available. They're just there. And I just listen to them when I'm walking to a cat's house, when I'm tidying my room, when I just want to feel a bit more connected to my faith and my druidry. If I am away from my Obod course material and my notebook, I can just turn on Druidcast and pick an episode that I like. And it's always very insightful, because they do like walking and talks. What's it called? Walk the talk? Talk the walk? Something about walking and talking. And the guests, they always like, not always, because C-word happened, so they had to do it online a little bit. But a lot of the episodes are done while they're walking through somewhere fun, and then you get like a bit of history about a place that you've never been to, and some of them describe the surroundings so beautifully that I can picture it in my head even though I'm not there. It's almost like image describing the walk. It's really great. And then you also get like the added bonus of sometimes there's like background noise, so really loud birds tweeting very occasionally, or the wind. A lot of people don't like the wind noise, but it's kind of really grounding to me. It's like, oh wow, these are real people going on a real walk, which I really enjoy. So I have been using that to supplement my Obod course. And obviously, reading books. I have got a big stack of books, which you can see off frame a little bit. I've got a big stack of books that I have been reading, and well, more collecting than reading, I'm not gonna lie to you. It's fine. But I have these books. Some of them I've been reading, some of them I have not yet read. Some of them I've read bits of, because I'm still working on the reading regularly thing. It's something I really want to do, but books have been really helping. So this one, Pagan Portals, Cailleach, by Rachel Patterson. I'm about halfway through this one, because she's like, well, the Cailleach is my goddess of choice. She chose me, however you want to say it. Then I have another one about the Cailleach, which I've not even started yet. Celtic Myths and Legends, because obviously Druidry goes back really far. I've always been interested in Celtic history, Celticness, Celtic pantheon. It's all really good, and I think this is just a really interesting book to have alongside that. And then this is a book that I had when I first started out in paganism, so I think I got this when I was about 16 or 17. I still lived in Cornwall then. And this was like my first, Druidry is really interesting, I really want to get into it, but I struggled to read this book a little bit. I need to go back and do it, because it's written in a style that at the time I really struggled to read, But I think now that I'm kind of a bit older and I've been reading so much science that can be a little dry, I think I will get on much better with it now, especially because of all the historical content that I've been learning through Druidcast, all the forums online, just research, deep diving, which I'll get onto in a minute. So I think I will have a better time reading this. It's on my list. And then Sacred Actions by Dana O'Driscoll. This is like a Wheel of the Year book, and the cover's really nice. It's like brown paper. It's really cool. So you don't have to start this at chapter one. And Druidcast did an episode talking to Dana about the book, which I listened to, and it was great, and I've read a little bit of it, but not as much as I want to. And yeah, so this is another book that I've been doing. So we go through each chapter is one of the wheels, one of the festivals, if that's what you want to call them. So we've got the Winter Solstice, Imolc, Spring Equinox, which I should have read, Beltane, which I will definitely be reading in the next month or so, I hope, Summer Solstice, Lunasar, Fall Equinox, Samhain, and a conclusion. So this is going to be really, really interesting. I wish I could say that I've read what any of those all the way through. I haven't. I recommend all of them though, even though I've not read all of them. I'll put titles and authors down in the description below if you're interested, but like this is not really an endorsement, it's just what I'm using, and if you're interested, go have a look. Another way that I've just been studying to be a druid is just spending time outside with green things, trees, and just existing as a person outside. I want to say meditating, but it's not really been meditating because I'm not very good at meditating. But just taking a minute to just be outside. The other day I lay down in like a patch of daffodils and it was the most at peace I have been in about 6 months. It was a fantastic 7.5 minutes. So I've just been doing that to really like connect and disconnect from just the stresses of my life. There are some, believe me, there are. My life is stressful. You probably don't think it is, but it is. Which kind of leads me on to my last point, is just doing deep dives in things that interest me about druidry. Because obviously with the Obod course, it's written, it's given to you in a certain order with the intent that you follow it in that order, and there are reasons for that. But sometimes the next lesson in the course is not something that makes my heart sing in that particular moment. It's like when you're at school and you've just come out of, for me it was biology, for others it might be music or art, and then you've gone into a subject that you really don't like very much. And it's not that I don't like the course content, it's like I'd rather do something else. So I just do something else so that I can really kind of, because I don't want to study out of resentment. I don't want to feel anything negative about what I'm about to be studying. I want to go into it with an open mind, not a, oh God, I can't be bothered for this today. If you can't be bothered, don't do it. Do something else. And then lastly, I've been attending some of the local druid-based rituals and moots. In Nottingham we have the Robin Hood moot, which was run by a druid, but it was multi-faith, and the open ritual kind of took on a druidic kind of algorithm. It was very druidy, and it worked for everyone. It wasn't just like you have to be a druid for this, or you have to be Wiccan, or like I don't know. It was great. It worked for everyone. So I went to one of those. I went to a couple of those, but one of them, really. Just hanging out with other druids and talking to other druids, engaging in like Facebook conversations. This is no longer a finally, is it? This is just a list of things I can't be bothered to talk about. But I'm in some of the Facebook groups for druids and pagans as a whole. Like learning about other people's paths, I think, is very important. And just practicing kindness, because druidry is also about kindness and justice and happiness and peace. Peace, most importantly. So I have been trying to practice peace where I can. So that's how I have been studying to be a druid. If you have any questions, put them down in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time with at least one bonus video every single month. I want a new outro because I hate saying that. See ya!